father William Mayer's childhood. What is this child going to be? So wondered the mother Pauline and the father Albert Mayer when he was born. A unique destiny lay in store for the newborn baby. William was born on September 12, 1870 in Scotch, a village in Canton Lucerne of Switzerland. His alertness, openness, intelligence and cheerful spontaneity marked his healthy growth.
Vocation to priesthood. While attending secondary school, William for the first time began to think of his future career. It was the dream of the young boy to be an architect. Interestingly enough, William fulfilled his boyhood dream, although in a manner which was completely different from what he had anticipated.
Father William Mayer, a priest for people, he was appointed as a curate in Hitscratch and thus became associated with the poor and the suffering. His sympathy and understanding for the inmates of the old age home urged him to direct his future work. A year later, in recognition of his intelligence, industrious nature and potential leadership, the church appointed him vice-rector of the seminary in Lucerne. The village girls coming to work in the city and with compassion of Jesus reflected in the gospel. In so far as you did this to the least of this of mine, you did it to me. He opened a house for these working girls called the Home of Mary, and soon a second home called the House of Joseph.
God's architect, his compassionate heart sensed the need of mother at childbirth. The time when a helping hand was essential, he confronted himself with a question. What more I have to put right if I knew that I would have to die today? He laid his new plan of founding a religious association of sisters because he desired only God's will. A writer with the cause. Two of his exceptional literary work that need to be mentioned are Bearing Sickness as a Christian and Dying as a Christian and Eucharist. His writing reveals to us that he was a man of God, a profound thinker, a great patriot and a social reformer.
Spiritual Testament of the Founder. The few notes left by him and the letters of advice written to the sisters give us a glimpse into the spirituality. When work meets the needs of the time, it indicates the will of God. Describing the aim and the work of the sisters, he writes, "The Society of St. Anne's has become an angel of charity. Angels do not die." He was so deeply united with the Jesus that he could see Jesus in everyone. Every letter of his paints for us a picture of his deep love of Jesus. In all his letters he traces, "Be truly loyal to this motto, for Jesus, for his love." The words, "You have nothing more important to do on earth than to live your life for him," defines his spirituality, and he demands the same for every sister. Cling like a creeper to the rock. He advises each sister to seek the will of God when he insists, "Have only one desire, do only one thing, Father. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven."
A founder, a man after the heart of God, Father William Mayer was a person with the clarity of perception and reflective attitude. After a short but a busy period of 15 years of priestly ministry, scarcely 2 years after starting of the society, he left for the land of eternal bliss on 8 February 1912.
A soul on fire. Within a short span of life on earth, he defined for us the deep meaning of gospel values, the mode of life to be lived, and how to respond to the crying needs of the time. While reflecting and analyzing his life here on earth, one comes to know him as a great mystery with a deep spirituality as he enjoyed a deep spiritual union with God. He has not died. He is alive today, since his inspiration and vision as well as mission are alive.